Hello. Riding to a different scenery, Waterdam. Just went to the motor store to pick up some chain oil because I run out. And I got a new chain, so it needs to be oiled a lot. And also checked for some gloves, but I couldn't find any. There isn't any haste on it, so that isn't a problem. And there's a nice way of testing the TomTom location. Again, the stability. Because I finally found a way to mount it onto this bike. I can easily take it off and I can put it on. That's about it. Now I wanted to talk to you guys about exotic pets. So what are exotic pets? Everything from on a hamster will be considered exotic pet. Dog and cat are domestic. Rabbits are domestic. Guinea pigs, they call most of the time as domestic. Some even still as exotic pets. Horse, cows are production animals. Sheep, pigs are production animals. So exotic pets, everything except that type of animals. And the Dutch government decided, well, it wasn't actually the Dutch government. There's a whole backstory to it, and it's actually only very interesting if you are from Holland. And if you are from Holland and you want to know more about this than my crappy explanation, you can view this link to PVA, or you can check this link where there's a petition you can sign. And then you also have this Facebook you can check out. They decided to ban almost every animal. Like, in the Netherlands you were allowed to keep almost every animal allowed. In Europe it's still that way. Primates are forbidden, which is logical in a way. And I think some of the big game animals are forbidden. Elephants, giraffe, tiger, lion. But for the rest you can keep it all. And I'm fine with that. I mean, you should be free to do what you want as long as you can do it properly and good. The panel that tested the animals, whether or not they were holdable, tested about 90 mammals. First list is only of mammals, and they tested about 90 mammals whether or not they were keepable in the Netherlands. Dog and cat weren't tested because you don't want to touch those, because you then have an army of angry Dutchmen at your doorsteps. And cows, horses, pigs, sheep were all accepted as a production animal, so they were allowed. But those were in those 90. But yeah, those 90 animals they choose were from, I think, 5,400 mammals. So less than 1%. Not enough, at least. You aren't allowed to keep a Siberian dwarf hamster, but you are allowed to keep a water buffalo in your house. Can you see it? A guy in an apartment. Child that wants a small pet. Well, we can't give you a small Siberian dwarf hamster for some fucked up reason, but you can keep a water buffalo in your apartment if you like. I mean, come on. I think this positive list is ridiculous. And I'm talking about mammals now because that's the first list, but the next list will be birds, which are all exotic, and reptiles, same story. People with reptiles are quite concerned because, well, you don't want to lose your hobby. People with birds at this moment are still very relaxed on it. They don't think it will happen. And that's the problem. Too many people are too relaxed about it. And that's going to kill the hobby. and the animal stores, of course. And after those two lists, the fish will also be being fucked in the ass. So it is something that should be more talked about. It almost hasn't got any media attention. The problem with that is, kijk, if they were attacking dogs and cats as well, which they should be, it would be all over the news and people demonstrating, and but they aren't, so a lot of people have something like more. And I think if you go in any store and ask people if you could keep a snake in your house, 9 out of 10 would say hell no. But if you ask people if you could keep a ferret or a water buffalo, they probably would say yes to the ferret and no to the water buffalo. The Dutch government does it exactly the other way around. If you ask me if you can keep an animal, any animal, I would probably say yes. But you should be able to keep them in a proper space. So a terrarium, a cage, a outside or inside, that is big enough to contain them. It's big enough for them to feel healthy, to be happy. So with some animals, like an elephant, you need like a horse ranch before you, I would say, well, yeah, now you can keep one. So whether or not you can keep an animal is very, very depending on the room you have. After that, can you deliver the proper resources like food, like lighting, like UVB, like water temperature, like building materials for nest or for homes? And as long as you can provide everything to make that animal feel healthy, I would say yeah, you can keep that animal. Primates are a big question mark. I don't have the idea that you can keep them properly, especially in the Netherlands. Big game like elephants, tigers and lions in the same story. I don't think you have the proper room in the Netherlands to keep them. But almost everything else, yeah, you should be able to keep them in the Netherlands. Or anywhere else, for that matter. As long as you have the proper room, the proper resources, the proper materials available for them, yeah, you should be able to take care of them. Yeah, for the Dutchies, check out these three links. For the Englishmen, please put in the comments, do you have any laws concerning animals in your country? What do you think about those laws? What do you think about keeping animals? Should there be any laws against or a front for them? And with that, I'm going to sign off.